We treat a lot of different conditions in the office. I will see patients from age 5 or younger all the way up to patients in their 80s or 90s. We have a very large practice in spinal deformities, so we treat scoliosis in children and adults. We treat kyphosis, which is a forward bending of the spine. We certainly treat back pain. We treat disc herniation, both in the low back and in the neck, which can cause pain in the arm. We will treat spinal infections, spinal tumors, and of course, because we are the faculty at the Shock Trauma Center, we treat spinal fractures. So we run the laundry list of all spinal conditions. We like to say we treat everything from the occiput, which is the base of the skull, to the coccyx, which is the bottom of the tailbone. The symptoms can be varied. The most common symptom that we see in the office is back pain. But many patients will come in without any back pain, but just leg or arm pain. Many patients don't recognize that if they have significant leg or arm pain, that it might be stemming from their back or neck. The most common type of patient I will see in the office is generally someone in their 30s or 40s who has been having back pain episodes off and on for most of their adult life, which is not uncommon, but for some reason, their pain has recently escalated to the point that their function is becoming limited. They're starting to miss time at work. They can't participate in the recreational activities that they want to. And they are concerned that this is going to continue to get worse and worse and worse. And they want an explanation for what's going on. The other very common patient we see is someone in the more senior years who, despite the fact that their back is not so much of a problem, they're beginning to develop pain that radiates into their legs. So spinal stenosis is the most common diagnosis in that category, and those patients often present with a history that when they try to stand or walk distances, they begin to get pain in their buttocks, going down the back of their legs into their calves. Many people say, I can't even wash the dishes. I wash two dishes and I have to go sit down. For the vast majority of people, we give them tools and strategies to help them manage their back pain so that they never require anything more aggressive. We will encourage patients to get involved in a regular exercise program. We know people who are more fit tend to tolerate their back pain better. Weight loss plays a role in the office. Smoking is also well known to increase the incidence of back pain in the general population. For the spinal stenosis patient, for the patients with nerve compression, it's a little different. Many people can be managed non-operatively, but at some point, if the nerve compression is sufficiently severe and does not respond to fairly simple types of maneuvers, surgery becomes much more of an option. Obviously, there's no amount of exercise that will take a pinched nerve and unpinch it. At some point, if the symptoms are interfering with lifestyle, surgical decompression is probably the best and most effective treatment. Our relationship with our patients, I think, is very personal. I think in an era where we live in a society where less and less time is spent with the patient and the doctor together, we work very diligently to try to give that face time to patients so they can feel comfortable and understand the nature of their problem and the reasons why we're choosing the treatments that we are choosing. So we have a doctor in the office for the spine team every day of the week. And if patients call with a problem, we will try to get that patient into the office to see one of us within 24 to 48 hours. Every patient who comes to the office is seen by the physician. And we will take the time to hear that patient's story and listen to them and order the appropriate diagnostic studies so that we can make a correct diagnosis and then come up with a treatment plan.